गुड आफ्टरनून स्टूडेंट्स. इन यस्टरडेज लेक्चर वी हैव सीन द वर्किंग ऑफ डिप्लीशन टाइप मेटल फ्री डिफिक मेटल ऑक्साइड सेमी कंडक्टर फील्ड इफेक्ट ट्रांजिस्टर. वी हैव सीन द कंस्ट्रक्शन टाइप्स ऑफ मॉसफेट एज वेल एज टर्मिनल्स ऑफ मॉसफेट. वाई इट इज़ कॉल्ड एज अ इंसुलेटेड गेट. इट इज़ ऑल्सो वी हैव सीन दैट द गेट टर्मिनल इज इंसुलेटेड फ्रॉम द होल device whole component, how it is insulated with the help of SiO2 layer. Then what is a depletion mode, what is a enhancement mode, we have seen in yesterday. We have seen the detailed working of MOSFET in depletion mode. So in this lecture we'll see the enhancement type MOSFET. Now figure shows a MOSFET with positive gate to source voltage. The positive gate to source voltage increases the number of free electrons passing through the channel. Greater is the voltage, greater is the number of free electrons passing through the channel, and this increases that is enhances the conductivity of the channel, and drain current increases. So because of this fact, positive gate voltage operation is called as an enhancement mode. And it will be interesting to know that the depletion type MOSFET can conduct even if gate to source voltage is zero. Hence, it is called normally on MOSFET. So you can see that if we increase the voltage near a gate to source voltage, then there is a number of free electrons will flow through the channel, and this will increases the conducting capacity of channel. It will enhances the conductivity of the channel. That's why this type of biasing, or we can say that this type of MOSFET is called as a enhancement type MOSFET. So if we put source to gate voltage zero, then also this MOSFET will work, as there is no channel because of free electrons. The electrons will flow through the terminals and drain current starts flowing through the MOSFET. Then without any gate to source voltage, it is also works. Hence it is called as a normally on MOSFET. You can see that there is a number of electrons are increased near the gate to source terminal, and it will increases the number of electrons inside the channel also. So they are free to conduct inside p-type material also. They are going towards substrate type also, because there is a increase in number of electrons. So this is the conditions given when VGS is equals to zero, both the junctions are reverse biased. So initially there is a no drain current will flow through the channel. If we increase the VGS voltage, that means positive voltage at the gate, if we increase, then at gate pressure holds to enter deeper region of the P substrate, and the electrons in P substrate and electrons in P substrate will get attractive to the towards the positive gate. The level of VGS that results in a significant increase in a drain current is called as a threshold voltage. Then this is the drain characteristics of enhancement type n-channel MOSFET. So it is nothing but the curve of drain current ID and drain to source voltage VDS. These curves are plotted for both positive and negative values of a gate to source voltage. And the curve shown above is for the curve VGS is equals to zero. Then we have put positive values for gate to source voltage. So there is a increase in ID current, and after some 5 to 6 volt range, the ID current achieves maximum value and it stabilizes there, which is IDSS, drain saturation current. Then this is the transfer characteristics of enhancement type MOSFET. that is it is the curve between VGS and gate to source voltage and drain current ID. So it may be noted from the curve that the region linear region in transfer characteristics, that is from 0 to 3 volt, it may be noted that the curve which is having the value from 0 to 3 volt of characteristics is similar to field effect transistor, but there is a curve extends for positive values of gate to source voltage. There is a increase in ID current after 4 voltage. So after that, ID starts increasing linearly with VGS voltage. So this is the linear region, that is shown with the help of transfer characteristics, which means the graph of VGS and ID. Then it operates only in enhancement mode. It differs in construction from depletion type MOSFET in sense that it has no physical channel. The figure shows the basic construction. Previous figure shows the basic construction of n-channel E MOSFET. It may be noted that P-type substrate extends up to silicon dioxide layer and it divides the channel physically into two parts. In the handwritten notes also it is explained. It is always operated with a positive gate to source voltage. When gate to source voltage is zero, the VDD supply tries to force electrons from source to drain. But presence of P region does not permit electrons to pass through it. So there is no drain current for VGS is equals to zero. Due to this fact, the enhancement type MOSFET is also called as a normally off MOSFET. Now if positive voltage is applied to gate, it induces negative charge in P-type substrate just adjacent to SiO2 layer. The induced negative charge is produced by attracting free electrons from source. When gate is positive enough, it can attract number of free electrons. This forms thin layer of electrons from source which stretches from source to drain. This layer of free electrons is called as an n-type inversion layer. The minimum VGS voltage which produces inversion layer is called as a threshold voltage, and it is denoted by VGS threshold, that is VT, we can say that. Then the value of drain current increases with increase in gate to source voltage, because inversion layer width increases for increase in value of VGS. These are the drain characteristics. Then this is the transfer characteristics. In transfer characteristics, it may be noted from figure that when VGS is less than threshold voltage, then there is no current. Initially zero current flows through, means up to 2 volts there is VGS is less than threshold voltage, so initially there is zero ID current. These are the some examples and formulas given. Just go through it. This formula is not very much important for our portion. This is also some formulas and examples are given just for reference. These are the symbols. Again, I am saying, I previously told you that symbols are very much important. Try to draw the symbols of diode, then NP and PNP transistor, then N-channel, P-channel, JFET, the symbol of MOSFET. So there is a enhancement. These are the enhancement type MOSFET symbol. So enhancement type symbol, the dotted line is shown between drain to source, whereas in depletion type the line is continuous drain to source. So note the difference. Again, for recognizing the channel, we have drawn the arrows. But the arrows are not given to gate terminal, it is given to SS, that is right hand side of the symbol. एंड इन जेफेट द एरो इज गिवन टू गेट टर्मिनल इट्सेल्फ. देन यू कैन सी दैट द एरो इफ एरो इज इनसाइड देन इट इज एन चैनल, इफ एरो इज आउटसाइड देन इट इज अ पी चैनल. सो ट्राई और प्रैक्टिस ऑल द सिम्बॉल्स, ट्राई टू प्रैक्टिस ऑल द सिम्बॉल्स, ड्रॉ इट इज केयरफुल बिकॉज द क्वेश्चंस ऑलवेज आर आस्किंग ऑन सिम्बॉल्स, 2 marks questions. Then this is a vertical MOSFET. In our syllabus, the vertical MOSFET is not given, but this is also fast switching speed MOSFET. These are the some characteristics given for your reference. Its switching speed is very good. Then reduced channel increases the increases resistance level, high current and high power rating. Then it has a positive temperature coefficient, means if we increase the temperature then there is a increase in conductivity of this MOSFET. Then switching time is faster. Then this is a CMOS, complementary CMOS. This is another type, this is also not in our syllabus. These are some characteristics of CMOS. It is used in a computer logic design. Then it has high input impedance, fast switching speed. So this is all about a MOSFET. We have completed our 4th chapter. So today I will give you 4th assignment. I complete it and upload it on given link. Thank you. Then this is the comparison is given between D MOSFET and E MOSFET. That is a symbol shown in first point. Then what is the difference? That the drain and source line is continuous line in depletion type, and in enhancement type it is shown with the help of dotted line. Then again the arrow is connected to source terminal. The inside arrow shows that N channel depletion type MOSFET, and outside arrow shows P channel depletion type MOSFET. Likewise here also, in enhancement type inside arrow means N channel, outside arrow means P channel. Note the difference carefully. Then insulating SiO2 layer is present between gate and channel in depletion type. Insulating SiO2 layer is present between gate and substrate. Again note the difference, insulating layer is between gate and channel, and here gate and substrate. For reference, see the construction which is given in the notes. Then N or P type channel is present. In enhancement type there is a no channel, because if when we increase gate to source voltage, then the conductivity of channel increases, because there is a large number of electrons starts flowing through the channel, and these electrons overflow through the channel and it will goes towards substrate for conduction. So channel will completely vanish from the construction, we can say that. So channel is not present. Then gate to source voltage can be positive or negative in depletion type, but in enhancement type it is only positive. Then in depletion layer, in depletion type MOSFET, it operates in 2 modes, depletion and enhancement, and in enhancement it is operated only in enhancement mode. Then in depletion type it is also called as a normally on MOSFET, and in enhancement type it is called as a normally off MOSFET, because if VGS voltage is less than threshold voltage, means if we put VGS equals to 0, then no drain current will flow through the MOSFET. Means initially it is in off position, so that's why it is called as a normally off MOSFET. Whereas in a depletion type MOSFET, if there is VGS is equals to 0, then there is also then ID current can flow through the channel at VGS is equals to 0. That's why it is called as a normally on MOSFET. Then in depletion type inversion layer is not formed, and in enhancement type inversion layer is formed.
which I have explained just now in a PPTs. Now this is the comparison. It's a very important point of this chapter. Then this is about the JFET biasing. As we have seen, the biasing of transistor. So biasing is a technique of applying external voltage to input side as well as output side. And why we doing this biasing? So to operate our field effect transistor as an amplifier, or we can use it like a on or off switch. So biasing techniques is used to stabilize the Q point near saturation region in JFET. So there are some methods which is given in our notes, that is fixed bias circuit, self bias circuit, voltage divider bias circuit. From that fixed bias and voltage divider bias we have seen in transistor also. So depending upon the biasing, if our JFET is in cutoff, then it will acts as open switch. If it is in saturation, then it will acts as an amplifier, and if it is in ohmic region, it will acts as a closed switch. So position of Q point remaining stable in JFET in spite of any variations in temperature or other parameters. Because of this advantage, the JFET acts as a fast switching device. So position of Q point or stabilization of Q point is done with the help of biasing. We have seen that stabilization in transistor also. Then this is a fixed bias configuration. The fixed bias configuration is provided with the help of capacitor C1, RG resistor and RD resistor. The capacitor C1 and C2 are coupling capacitor. It is used to couple the AC signal to the input side, and it will remove the DC signal from supply. So it is similar to base bias of bipolar transistor. Then minus VGG voltage is ensure that gate source junction is reverse bias. Then base bias circuit cannot provide stable Q point because it needs a power supplies for operation. Then for DC voltage, we have applied the KVL voltage as we have applied it in doing the biasing calculation in transistor also. So by applying KVL to input loop, we'll get VGS plus VGG equals to 0, means VGS is equals to minus VGG. Then we have found the ID equation, that is ID is equals to IDSS, that is saturation current, in bracket 1 minus VGS upon VP. VP means pinch off voltage. We have seen what is pinch off voltage and definition of pinch off voltage. Then expression for output loop, that is VDD minus IDRD minus VDS is equals to 0. So VDS is equals to VDD minus IDRD. These expressions are important. Just go through it. Then this point we have covered in our presentation also. Then this is about a self bias configuration. Self bias configuration, in that we have connected two resistor, the parallel combination of two resistor, that is RG and RS, which is connected between gate and source. Coupling capacitor is connected to input C1, and C2 is output coupling capacitor. Now coupling capacitor function, we know it is used to provide the AC components to the input as well as output. Then RG and RD resistor produces the voltage drop, required voltage drop near gate and source. So this will increases the stability of Q point, and this is used to provide the biasing to get to source area. Then resistor RS is called as a feedback resistor, which is also used to increase the gain of the device, or it will also increases the drain current. Then how stabilization is done: if VDD is applied, then drain current increases, which will increase the voltage drop near resistor RS. The increase in voltage drop increases the reverse gate to source voltage, which decreases the width of channel. And if width of the channel reduces, then it will reduces the drain current, and it will automatically compensate, and stabilization is achieved. Then DC analysis. For DC analysis, we have provided the voltage law to input as well as output. From that, we have find out the equation for VGS is equals to minus IDRS, and for ID, the equation IDS is 1 minus VGS upon VP bracket square. This equation is solved. Then for VDS, we have achieved VDS is equals to VDD minus ID in bracket RD plus RS. Then this is the voltage divider bias, is the same like a transistor. The voltage divider bias, how to identify voltage divider bias? That means two resistor R1 and R2 is connected to gate source and drain source area. These R1 R2 provides voltage divider bias. Then RD resistor used to compensate the sudden increase in ID. Then RS is a feedback resistor. It is used to increase the gain of the device, as well as it will provide the, or it will resist sudden increase in source current. Then DC analysis is given. We have find IG is equals to 0, then IR1 is equals to IR2, which is equals to VDD upon R1 plus R2. This is voltage divider bias rule. So from VG, from that we have derived the equation for VG, that is R2 upon R1 plus R2 into VDD. Then we have applied a KVL at the input side, which gives VG minus VGS minus IDRD. This is the voltage drop near the drain source region, which gives us the equation VGS is equals to VG minus IDRS. And for VDS, we have applied the KVL equation at the output side, that is VDD is equals to IDRD plus IDRS plus VDS, which gives us VDS is equals to VDD minus ID in bracket RD plus RS. Then the comparison of comparison between biasing technique is given. Biasing we have done: fixed bias, self bias, and voltage divider bias. Then number of DC power supply we required in fixed bias 2, in self bias 1, in voltage divider bias 1. Expression for VGS is given for 3 bias. Then source resistance is absent in fixed bias and it is present in self and voltage bias. Then negative feedback is absent in fixed bias, and for a self and volt divider it is present. Bias stabilization in fixed bias cannot be provided. Then in self bias it is better than fixed bias, and in voltage divider it is better than self bias. So generally we'll prefer the voltage divider bias because it gives a good stabilization for Q point, as well as it will provide the good input output power gain. So that's why the voltage divider bias is preferred. This point we have covered in presentation, that is the characteristics of JFET, drain characteristics, transfer characteristics. Then comparison of JFET and BJT is remaining. The BJT is current control device and JFET is voltage control device. BJT is bipolar, that means the conduction is possible due to majority as well as minority charge carriers. But if it is unipolar, the conduction happens only due to majority charge carriers. The thermal runaway cannot damage the BJT, and thermal away cannot take place in JFET because of that insulated gate, because we have made some changes in construction. Then in BJT there is low input impedance, in BJT there is a high input impedance. Impedance is the ratio of resistance to the current. Then noise generates BJT it is high, and in JFET it is very less. The transfer characteristics of BJT is linear, MOSFET it is not linear. Then it has BJT has high sensitivity to applied signal, in JFET it is less sensitive. BJT is larger in size, FET is smaller in size. The symbols of BJT and JFET is given. Observe that symbols carefully. Then parameters of JFET is given, that is dynamic resistance. Dynamic resistance means the ratio of change in drain to source voltage to the change in ID current when we kept VGS is equals to constant. Then transconductance is the ratio of change in drain current to the change in gate to source voltage by keeping VDS constant. Then amplification factor is change in drain to source voltage to the change in gate to source voltage. Then the relation between transconductance and drain resistance is given, which is denoted by mu RD into GM mu. Then input resistance is the ratio of gate to source voltage to the saturation gate current. Then input capacitance, it is reverse bias gate to source voltage. Then advantages and disadvantages of JFET is given. It has high input resistance, better thermal stability, very small input current, hence no loading on input side, produces less noise, long life, small size, higher power gain. And disadvantage is that it cannot be used as a current amplifier. Value of transconductance is very low, voltage gain is very low, and it requires some special handling precautions. Then application, it is used as an amplifier, used as a switch, it is used in a ADC and DAC, means it is a digital circuits, analog to digital converter or digital to analog converter. Then it is used in amplitude modulation, means if there is a weak signal, then it is used to increase the strength of the signal, which is called as amplitude modulation. Then it is used in sample and hold circuit, which is used, sample and hold circuits are used in a digital devices. Then it is used as a voltage variable resistor. So these are the some points which are left from us while teaching the chapter in presentation. Once again, read notes carefully, go through notes, try to practice all the diagrams and symbols. Thank you.